Hello everyone, welcome to Don's Meditations and Hoop Life Sports and Entertainment. In this video I'm going to share interesting news about the Clippers. Paul George may be leaving, but just listen to what Skip Bayless got to say, man. Right after Shannon, I like what Shannon be saying. Shannon, he talks the truth, but Skip, he consistently makes excuses. Check it out.
Should they do this?
Skip, I think they are going to do it for the simple fact, and I think the most likely person to leave is probably Paul George. They need to get some of that draft capital, but they gave up, Skip, and I don't know if they're going to get it back in the picks, because I don't think Paul George is going to command from some, you know, you're going to get what you gave up to get it. But if the Nets are willing to part with, say, Dinwiddie or Caris LeVert or Jared Allen, I think that's a move that the Clippers would be willing to make. Now, I don't know, because people are like, oh, they're going to be, but all those golf ball guys at Brooklyn, Skip, they need the ball. LeVert needs the ball. KD, Kyrie, Dinwiddie, they need the ball. So it's going to be very, very interesting. Now, Trez Harrell is going to be very interesting because he did not play in the bubble and in the playoffs as well as he did in the regular season when he won earned the end of the year. So people are going to be looking at that. I just think the thing is that this is a Kawhi needs a point guard. You look at Kawhi. When he had his best year, Skip, what did he have? He had a true point guard. He had Tony Parker, and he had Kyle Lowry. Now, nothing against Pat Bev, but Pat Bev is not that. Kawhi doesn't want to have the ball all the time and make plays for someone else. He wants someone that can make plays for him. Mm-hmm. So I do believe they're going to break this up, and I believe the most likely candidate to leave is Paul George. They got too many billboards. They got too many Kawhi Town and all these commercials for Kawhi to get out of town. But I believe the most likely scenario, Skip, is Paul George will exit the Clippers.
I cannot tell you how much I disagree with everything you just said.
Okay.
I don't know what they will do. I know what they should do, which is nothing. They just made the one move they had to make, and that was to elevate Ty Lue to replace Doc Rivers.
Okay.
That's why you and your Lakers are going to be in trouble next year, because you should have been in trouble this year. This team, this Clippers team, had a combined missed 114 regular season games for injuries.
So what?
33
excuses.
Different starting lineups during the regular season.
I want to hear that.
And then this team went to the bubble, some went to the bubble, some didn't want to go to the bubble. And
see, there you go. You hear him? Start making excuses for the Clippers already. Making excuses after excuses after excuses. There ain't no excuse. Everybody went to the bubble, bro.
Till our friend Jared Dudley said on a podcast last week, those boys did not want to be in that bubble.
They ain't really tough like us.
Okay, well, I'll give you that one for now. But the point was, nothing went right for a team that was favored to win it all going into the playoffs. Vegas said that's the best team.
So
why would break up a team that the odds makers proclaimed was the best team going into the playoffs?
Did it really look like
that? The odds makers kept favoring the Clippers over the Nuggets in individual games far more than they favored the Lakers
right.
over the Nuggets.
So Vegas don't know what they don't know. You can't rely on Vegas.
You're so lucky. LeBron got the second biggest break of his career when the Nuggets upset the Clippers.
Oh, you thought that was an upset?
No, the first break was when
that was no upset. Hold up. That was no upset, Skip. They handedly beat the Clippers. Handedly, it was no luck, it was none of that. Let me rewind that, what he said.
LeBron got the second biggest break of his career when the Nuggets upset the Clippers.
Upset. You thought that was an upset?
No, the first break was when Ray Allen hit that shot from the corner.
Now you're bringing up something old.
But the point was,
come on.
Did you see one time the Nuggets blow the Clippers off the court?
Yeah. No, they handedly beat them.
Stop it.
What do you mean, stop it?
They were up by 12.
What do you mean, hold up. What do you mean, stop it? It was, the Nuggets handedly beat the Clippers. It was no luck. It was none of that, what you're saying. They handedly beat them convincingly.
They got beat by 20.
You saw
it wasn't no luck at all.
For long stretches of each closeout game, they were up 16 in the first closeout, 19 in the second closeout, and 12 in the final closeout. They flexed their muscles. They showed you they were clearly superior.
But they weren't working it out, so they had no muscle.
Okay, yeah, whoops. You can have all, you can have all your jokes that you want to have because you won. You got every break.
Man, no,
you
had, what break?
The easiest path to a ring in the history of paths.
Wow.
It all broke right for you.
We had the same path.
Thank you.
We got to travel the same exact road you were on.
Yes.
But the difference is that our mentality. I told you, Skip, the greatest key to survival is not size, it's not strength, it's not speed, it's adaptability. Your inability to adapt to your surroundings, which was the bubble. Our ability to adapt to our surroundings, which was the bubble, was the key to us winning the title
Me
being able to gloat, and you losing and you being sad.
That's
now, I keep telling you, oh, Kawhi the cyborg, oh, he feel that. I can't tell. I can't tell.
You could tell all year.
He was all upset. Did you see it, Randy Raven? I didn't pass the ball for that bleep. He just climbed up. He was like, whoa, Kawhi, what going on? But my guy, y'all want to try to paint my guy as being difficult to play with.
Right.
My guy bring rings. And look here, if you don't have a ring, if you want to get a ring, you want to get married, come see my guy. Because my guy put rings on people's fingers. Miami, they wanted some more ring.
Yeah.
My guy got them a ring.
Yeah.
They went back to Cleveland. Yeah. L.A. hadn't had a ring in almost two and a decade.
Exactly.
Everybody got rings.
Yes.
Jeannie, the first female in a major sport. No, I think Georgia Frontier was first.
I think she was.
But hey, basketball. So never mind, whatever. Jeannie got this thing right, and we gonna every you still remember y'all were talking crazy. Oh, they should think about trading LeBron. Oh, he over the hill. Oh, he got hurt. Now everybody, that crow, they tell me crow tastes like whale sometimes. You cook it, get it right. Don't overcook it, don't let it get chewy. It tastes like whale. How that crow tastes it right now?
Well, you tell me next year when the Clippers win it all.
Oh, my
y'all
God.
Y'all should stay as is and go right back into where they were.
Let me tell you why you're not going to win it. Because the Lakers are not going to stay as is. That's what because I know. Go James, no, we can't stand Pat.
I don't get the reference to Goat James.
You
it sounds
do
like
get
it's
it.
Just another goat in the barnyard.
No, he not.
There's Goat James and Goat Tom and Charlie.
This is a hater, man.
Tom Brady, Goat James is where it's at in basketball. Now, I don't like to do cross-reference with sports or anything like that because it's too hard. Because when you're in football, you only play one side of the ball. Basketball, you can influence baseball. You can hit, pitch, catch, and do all the other things. I get all that. But in basketball, Goat James is where it's at. And I told you we going to win it in six. Told you we go five. That's what we do, Skip. You want a ring? Who wants a ring? Who wants a ring? Dwight Howard said, you know what? I'm going to put all my pride aside. I want a ring.
Exactly.
Who wants a ring? Who wants a ring? Dwight Howard said, you know what? I'm going to put all my pride aside. I want a ring. Here we go. AD said, I need to get up out of here. The food is great. I love the gumbo. I love the etouffee. I love the beignet. I love all that. But I want a ring. You come to L.A., boom. So if you want a ring.
It's been a long time since you won a ring.
Joe Harris, you want a ring? Bogdanovich in Sacramento, you want a ring? You want a ring? Come see you. Come see me.
Really?
I'll make it happen. Jared Dudley wanted a ring. You left at Dud's. Yeah, well, Dud is a champ now.
Yep. He's a COVID champ.
Wow.
So I loved what Ty Lue said yesterday because obviously the void at the top of this team has been leadership. Because Kawhi is not a take over the locker room kind of a leader. He leads by example. But Ty Lue said yesterday, you are not going to have the best players be the natural leaders at all times. It doesn't happen like that. I think a lot of the leadership has to come from me, said Ty Lue.
Yeah.
He can do that.
Yeah.
He also said that he will hold these players accountable.
Yeah, you should.
And Steve Ballmer indicated he would hold them more accountable than Doc was holding them accountable.
Good. Hey, guess what? No more load managing. No more load managing.
Ty Lue did question that.
Yes.
He was going to re-examine that concept.
My guy, you're 17 playing, giving that work. Right. He take it off every other night. Mm-hmm. I wish I might give it off to you.
Yeah.
But don't worry about it. All that's going to be, you can do whatever you want to. You can play him every night.
Ty Lue guided LeBron to his one ring in Cleveland, and he's going to guide the Clippers to their first ring of several with the other team in LA.
I just want you to know, tell me one thing. Who you going to get to do something with AD? That's why the Golden State Warriors went and begged KD to come there.
Exactly.
Because there was no answer for that.
For LeBron.
You still haven't told me who they're going to get. Did you see what Jamal Murray did to them, those two guys?
Exactly.
Did you see what Luka did to those two guys?
Thank you.
Did you think y'all can see us?
Thank you.
On what date?
Thank you.
Did you have to face us in the Western Conference Finals?
We didn't need to. You guys couldn't even beat the Nuggets.
Should I shoot this or not? I don't know.
Hold up. You guys couldn't even beat the Nuggets.
Conference Finals, that's a whole different beast.
Yeah.
And all of a sudden, AD's going, should I shoot this or not? I don't know.
Get out of here.
I sent out the invitation. Mm. Come. Mm-hmm. You guys didn't even show up.
Exactly. Exactly.
Did you not break down? Did you not like the outfit that you had?
Thank you. What happened?
We circled the dates on our calendar, and we were looking ahead to those dates.
We told you to save the date. We told you in advance to save the date.
Exactly.
And then what happened?
What happened, Skip?
Cancun and golfing playing on that date, and there you went.
Come on, bro.
Get in here, Skip. 1, 2, 3. 1, 2, 3, Cancun. Bam Bam on the beach with Tim's right now. Shuffling, good. Wheel spread side to side.
Exactly. I want you to gloat and gloat and gloat for the whole offseason because you lucked into one. Finally got one right.
No.
And you should enjoy it while it lasts because it will not last.
What happened to a way off P?
Yeah.
A way off P. Is that what they call it?
Playoff P?
No, way off.
Yeah.
He would hit the side of the back. Even what you call him does mention that. St. Paul George hit the side of the backboard.
Yep.
How you do that? You have to aim at it. I mean, you got to do that, Skip.
What happens,
Skip? He's good at it. I mean, he hit the side of the back. I'm like,
damn.
Come on, man.
Then he thought he was going to get a couple of points for that. Let that have been LeBron.
Right, exactly.
Scored 2 points in the fourth quarter. Exactly. In the second half of Game 7. Because you do know we got the highest scoring average in Game 7's history. We average a 35. That's what we do.
What you gotta say?
I did see in that closeout Game 5 playing the whole fourth quarter and just piling it up.
With no pile-ups, Skip.
Yeah.
I just want to know who thought I just want to know what basketball aficionado thought those two jokers were better than LeBron and AD.
Did you just call Kawhi a joker?
Both of them two jokers.
Shannon, we are
the champions.
You know what they say.
Also get a ring?
All right, I'm going to get me a ring. I'm going to get me a ring. Now, mine might be pecuniary zirconia, but I'm going to get me a ring. And flash it every time I come out of here.
You know what you're going to get? Karma. Karma.
Wow.
And you know what they say about it?
You know what? You're right, Skip. That's the thing I love about karma. Because sometimes karma is like, you got to wait years. And sometimes it's like Amazon Prime. They drop it off the next day.
Yep.
We'll see you later, Grandma. Thank you